Hi, everybody. It's Dr. Sam Robbins. Now, I've got a question from one of my viewers asking if lifting weights will make me short. And this is an interesting question because growing up, I was told to not lift weights because it would make me short. In fact, I was told to go play basketball if I wanted to grow up tall, and actually not to play soccer either, since that'll make me short. Of course, this is just idiotic and stupid. Playing basketball doesn't make you tall. It just happens to be that tall people play basketball. And playing soccer doesn't make you short either. Again, just happens that shorter people tend to play soccer. And similar to lifting weights, most, you know, muscular people just happen to be shorter because they don't need to gain as much muscle to look, you know, big and muscular. Versus someone like me who's actually 6'3", I'm tall. I need to gain a lot more muscle to fill out my large frame. So it's a lot more work for me. However, certain exercises can actually cause damage to your spine, not allowing you to get as tall as you could. Additionally, some exercises can actually improve your height, making your shoulders and rib cage bigger if you do them during puberty and up to the age of maybe around 21 to 23 or so while you're still growing. And I'll get to the exercises in a minute. However, genetics aside, the secret to getting taller is to actually lower estrogen, all right, and increase your testosterone and also your GH and IGF levels at the same time. You see, estrogen fuses the ends of the bones and thus prevents them from growing. This is why girls are actually taller than boys when, you know, everyone first starts puberty. But after about a year or two of puberty, once the estrogen shoots up a lot, the ends of the bones fuse and the growth and height slows down dramatically for these women, for these girls. Yet the boys, they keep getting taller and taller, but it happens slowly because they don't have as much estrogen and they have higher testosterone. And when you have a lot more growth hormone and IGF levels, your bones will keep growing because, again, the ends haven't fused yet because of the high estrogen. In fact, this is why women who are typically have, you know, really naturally big breasts are also shorter, while taller women generally have smaller breasts, again, due to estrogen. And you probably heard the saying about guys who are short, fat, bald, and hairy. Well, the short and fat is due to higher estrogen, and the bald and hairy is due to higher DHT levels. And in both of these cases, these men also happen to have lower testosterone levels. Again, however, all of this only matters if you're under the age of 23 and you're still going through puberty. Again, if your goal is to get taller. And yes, genetics does play the biggest role here. However, if done correctly, you can actually naturally grow an extra 2 to 4 inches or more. And yes, I've seen this many times. Now, regarding the exercises that can potentially keep you shorter, don't do anything that compresses the spine. This means no squats, overhead presses, deadlifts, shrugs, and similar exercises. Instead, focus on doing pull-ups and chins and not machine pull-downs. There's a big difference. You basically want to pull yourself up, and then when you lower yourself down at the bottom, hang for an extra 2 seconds and stretch everything out. You see, this makes your shoulders wider by stretching out your scapula around your back and shoulders, and it also decompresses your spine, which will help accelerate growth for your nerves, your CNS, and your bone growth. Of course, there are also diet factors as well, but that's for another video. However, just to keep it simple, do your best to eat as natural as possible and eliminate any foods that can increase your estrogen and decrease your testosterone. Now, if you want more information on increasing testosterone and decreasing estrogen, just scroll down below to the description area and click the link and watch the next special video about that topic. Well, that's it for today. Don't forget to leave your questions and comments below and make sure you watch the next video about increasing your testosterone levels, and you can click that link below in the description area. As always, thanks for listening and have a happy and healthy day.